Inspector General is opening an investigation into Republican charges that the FBI and DOJ were biased in their work on the Trump-Russia probe. This move stops short of fulfilling calls from many in the GOP for a special counsel to look into the matter. Tonight, correspondent Peter Ducey tells us why some people see an inherent conflict. Good evening, Peter.
Good evening, Brett. These questions about whether or not the FBI's surveillance capabilities were abused for political purposes ahead of the 2016 election are no longer just coming from Republican members of Congress, because the official with the resources to root out criminal violations at the FBI has opened a case.
The Federal Bureau of Investigation is now under investigation itself by the Justice Department Inspector General, trying to see if anyone in the ranks broke the rules when convincing federal judges to sign off on the surveillance of an American citizen. Inspector General Michael Horowitz says, quote, "As part of this examination, the OIG also will review information that was known to the DOJ and the FBI at the time the applications were filed from or about an alleged FBI confidential source." Republicans alleged in the Nunes memo that information from former British spy Christopher Steele, compiled in an unverified dossier, was key to that FISA warrant. This announcement comes as the FBI director Christopher Wray doubles the number of staffers helping sort through documents that Republican lawmakers subpoenaed because they were so delayed, from 27 staffers to 54. Wray writes that, quote, "The actual number of documents responsive to this request is likely in the thousands. Regardless, I agree that the current pace of production is too slow." By dramatically expanding the number of staffers assigned to sift through documents Republicans want, Wray is defying Democrats like the ranking member of the House Judiciary Committee, Gerald Nadler, who recently said, quote, "It seems that this subpoena is intended to speed up that production, to pivot the discussion back to Hillary Clinton and divert attention from the chaos surrounding the Trump administration and allegations involving the Trump campaign." The order to beef up the Bureau's staff assigned to help Congress came straight from the top, according to a DOJ insider who tells Fox, quote, "Senior staff on both sides of the street have met on this, and the FBI is getting called to the carpet. The attorney general is angry with how slow the process has moved when it comes to requests from Congress to the FBI." But some Republicans still think Sessions is acting like an Obama appointee.
I'm sorry, but Attorney General Sessions, I don't see much of a difference between him and Loretta Lynch and Eric Holder. I mean, what's the difference? When you issue a subpoena from Congress, it's just a suggestion, it's just a request. There's no urgency that you have to hit it by the deadline.
These extra FBI staffers now working to speed up their response to Republican requests for documents are not just planning to produce information about FISA abuse. They are also tasked with finding emails and texts and memos about the Clinton server investigation, as Republicans continue to probe why nobody ever got in trouble for that. Brett?
Peter, thank you.